So, we have annular solar eclipse coming on this Sunday, 21st June 2020. And this is a very, very special eclipse, and that's why it is much talked about. Firstly, this is happening on Sunday, and that too on a summer solstice day, when the day is the longest in the year. And the tithi also is a dual tithi. Actually, Amavasya is there, okay, up to 12:10 p.m. that day. After that, there is Pratipada. So we have to consider it as dual masas, because Jyeshtha is getting over and the Ashada is setting in. So, two masas. And even in a dual sign, like, you know, Gemini or Mithun Rashi, which is a dual sign, Dvi Swabhava Rashi, that's called in Hindi. And in dual stars, in two stars, okay, Mrigashira, third and fourth Charana, and then, you know, like Adra, which occurs after 1 p.m. in first three charanas, 1, 2, 3 charana after that. And of course, it is a Amavasya or a new moon day. So naturally the sun and moon are going to be together, and Rahu, because he is causing eclipse. Apart from him, there is also Gemini, in Gemini. Mercury, planet Mercury, who rules Gemini, is also in the retrograde motion. He is with these three planets. And on the other hand, other side of the axis, that is completely diagonally opposite or completely 180 degrees away, Ketu and Pluto are conjuncting in Sagittarius. So in all, we are having Mercury, Jupiter, Venus, Saturn, Pluto, Rahu and Ketu. All these are retrograde or Vakrigati. And it's only Mars who is in direct motion. I have made a very detailed video on, you know, solar eclipse. It is on the YouTube. You may watch it if it interests you. And today I will be discussing remedies and for each zodiac sign. And I'll give you again a little bit of information about the effects of this eclipse. And it begins in Mumbai. As far as Mumbai is concerned, 10 o'clock it begins, 10:01, like, you know, and maximum or a peak eclipse is at 11:38 a.m. and ends at 1:28 p.m. This period may differ from place to place as per the latitude and longitude. You need to check that. And Sutaka or Veda, that Kala begins, like, you know, inauspicious time we call it. It begins actually on the previous day at 9:59 p.m. That is on 20th. Now, annularity, the ring, this is the annular solar eclipse, Kankana Surya Grahana. So, we are able to see the rim of the sun, right? So, that is only for 38 seconds. All right. Now, for kids and senior citizens, like, you know, sick and pregnant ladies, Sutaka can begin at 6:02 in the morning on 21st itself. And this eclipse can be seen in North India, South Pakistan, and Saudi Arabia, and UAE. And some parts of Central Africa and Nepal. It will not be seen in North America, South America, then it won't be seen in France, Italy, Germany, Spain and UK. It will not be seen in those places. Now let us understand. Since the shadow cast on the sun is about 99.4%, the effects of this eclipse will be felt for 3 months. It will have effects for the next 3 months. That is from 21st June to 21st September 2020. So what are the likely outcomes or what are the effects going to be? Let me just quickly take you through. First thing is the political disturbance. So instability, then possibility attempt on the life of politicians or death of politicians, natural or otherwise. And also, politicians may end up in jail as whatever they have been doing, you know, the hidden things will get exposed. That possibility is also there. And death of celebrities. Celebrities means I'm not talking of world famous or, you know, nationwide famous, but all popular figures and, you know, public figures, and those death is predicted. And economic ups and downs. And worldwide, there is going to be heavy loss in business. And then, you know, price war is going to show up. essential goods may soar at very high price, and crimes and thefts and cheating and digital attacks and cyber crimes may also increase. And floods, then cyclones, heavy rains, and even tremors and earthquakes and volcanic eruptions can cause a lot of damage to property and life both. Like, life, when I say, I'm talking of all the forms of life, not just human beings. And people may be ill-treated at organization level, sacked and harassed by the employees. And big or small, it doesn't matter. But, and it may lead to unrest, and people might revolt against their organization, whatever setup, big or large. And cases of COVID may increase. Definitely, they will be on the rise. I don't think immediately after the lockdown, it's good. Actually, the challenging period will begin after the eclipse. It means after the lockdown is lifted. It's going to create further havoc. So we all need to be very, very careful. And see, if you are able to control it, or bring it under control, or a vaccine is found, it's not going to be that easy to find the vaccine also. But something else may spring up, something similar to COVID, which is causing confusion and not able to, you are not able to understand the nature of this pandemic might break. So please be very careful. And also, world war-like situation can arise, wherein most of the countries will be participating. US will be mostly taking the lead, and India also is definitely going to, join. So some of the sufferings, it is predicted over here, so that can't be avoided. And war is not going to be actually as it happened in the past. This I have detailed in the other video also. Please watch that. Now, what is the positive outcome? Always this is going to be like this and it's going to devastate everybody. No, some positive outcomes will also be there. See, first thing is people will become tech savvy. Now we are already experiencing, because of COVID, we are sitting at home and everybody is now, learning the digital ways and, continuing the work from home situation. Schools are functioning from home, all that. And also people will become self-reliant, and there may be a paradigm shift in their priorities in life. This is a very important point I wanted to drive at. It is not going to be just a temporary phase. Immediately after the lockdown is shifted, we will call all the mates and again start our old nature of life. It's not going to be like that. So it might create a proper shift, paradigm shift for us. And that is one positive thing I would, come out with. And some new inventions also, might come up in the digital world, or AI, artificial intelligence, or machine learning. All these things have a better chance to come. Now, what precautions you have to take during the eclipse? See, do not see the eclipse with a naked eye. Whether it's good for your Rashi or not good for your Rashi, I wouldn't advise it. Don't with naked eyes or without naked. With using the glasses. Not safe at all, don't do it, because a highly polluted environment will be there at that time. And don't eat any heavy meals. It's better if you fast during the period what I mentioned, but if you can't fast for some reason, then at least take lighter vegetarian meal like soups and salads and all that. So avoid any heavy meal at that time. As I mentioned earlier, certain sector, pregnant women, small children, senior citizens are exempted. And chant mantra during the eclipse, whatever mantra, what you know, or what your guru has given, or what you believe in, you chant that. I'm also going to give you certain mantras as per your zodiac signs. So if you want, you could chant that also. Now let me suggest some remedies for all the 12 zodiac signs. The first Rashi is Mesha Rashi or Aries. You need to guard your relations with your siblings. What do I mean by this? Be careful, because whatever damage you cause by words is going to remain for a very long time. So especially during this time, you might feel that inbuilt anger within you for some reason. So, but try to discipline yourself and, don't blurt out or don't vent out on that. And during eclipse time, you could chant this Bija mantra. Om Kram Kreem Kraum Saha Bhaumyaya Namaha. If you can't get this one, then very simple one is Om Am Angarakaya Namaha. Om Am Angarakaya Namaha. This is again mantra for you know Mars. And after the eclipse is over, you could donate some red cloth or you know red bangles or masoor dal and gur, something that is red, to people who are needy or at least to the temple. Now the next Rashi what I'm going to take up is Rishabh Rashi or Taurus. Now you need to guard your relation with your family members, because what happens is most of the time it is really, you know, like I wonder why it is like that. People are, I've seen so many people very polite, very nice and talking very sweetly because they want to impress others and you know, but at home with their own dear and near ones, they are pathetic. I'm using this word, sorry for that, but they don't know how to behave. They start, you know, picking up on them and trying to constantly criticize them and show that they are something. All these things are very bad. You shouldn't indulge in these things, because you should have that attitude first. Let me please my people who are close to me, because they are the ones who are going to be with you forever, not the outsiders. Anyway, I'm not saying that you behave bad with outsiders, but your behavior has to be consistent. So you have to chant this mantra, Shukraka mantra, like, you know, Om Dram Dream Dram Saha Shukraya Namaha. If you can't get this, no problem. You can just say Om Shum Shukraya Namaha. And after the eclipse is over, please donate white cloth, ghee, then agarbatti or dhoop or perfumes or even silver as your pockets permit. Now the next Rashi is Mithun Rashi or Gemini. You need to be very careful. Don't be overconfident. Eclipse is happening in your own sign actually. So don't develop any negative approach anywhere, whether at work or at home. Men may chant Gayatri Mantra. And everyone may chant this Budka Bija Mantra, that is Om Brahm Breem Brahm Saha Budaya Namaha. Or you, if you can't get this, you could chant Om Bum Budhaya Namaha. Okay, and you could donate all the green things, like, you know, green cloth or, you know, moong, like green grams, green bangles, whatever that is green, you could donate that. And the next moon sign is Karka or Cancer. This eclipse is not very good for you either. Again, you need to focus one thing, like be careful about your behavior with your own family members. Plus, any health problem, little also, if it is surfacing, please be very careful. Don't neglect it. If you neglect, it may lead to something else. And meditation will help you to control your mind and calm you down. And your mantra should be for Chandra. So, Om Shram Shreem Shraum Saha Chandraya Namaha. If you can't get this, no problem. You can just simply say Om Cham Chandraya Namaha. That also is fine. Now we'll move on to the next Rashi, that is Leo or Simha Rashi. So your prayer has to be for Sun Lord. Okay. So Om Ram Reem Ram Saha Suryaya Namaha. And also you can chant Aditya Hrudayam, and men can chant Gayatri Mantra. And donating wheat, jaggery, and anything that is red kind of thing, you know, or red cloth will help you actually to ward off the ill effects. And you need to control your anger and take care while you are dealing with your children. Okay, so the next one is Virgo or Kanya. You may get some kind of a difference with your father, especially if you are working with your father or you are sharing the same business. In a sense, you know, it may happen like this. Some project you want to take up or some business you want to advance, your father advises against it. You won't listen, but you end up losing money. So those kind of things are same. So be careful before you take any decision. And don't take tension. Some mental stress is possible over here. As it is, you know, Virgo or Kanya Rashi people are all the time worrying. If they don't have any worry, they will worry about why I don't have any worry. That kind of a mentality, you know, for Kanya Rashi. So don't do that. So you could donate green cloth or green gram after the grahan is over. And for you also, you have to chant a Bija Mantra of Buddha. Om Brahm Breem Brahm Saha Budhaya Namaha or Om Bum Budhaya Namaha. Then the next one is Libra or Tula Rashi. You need to avoid unnecessary travel and learn to be calm. Don't get agitated over small things. एंड चैंट शुक्र का बीज मंत्र ओम द्राम द्रीम द्रौम सह शुक्राय नमः. इफ यू कांट गेट इट फाइन ओम शुम शुक्राय नमः सिंपल वन. And you also could donate the same thing, white things, what I suggested for Rishabh Rashi. So, agarbatti and all perfumes and all these things, like, you know, white cloth or anything that is related to it. Then, next one is Scorpio or Vrishchika. Avoid new or important work at least till 16th July. The period is not very good for starting any new venture or getting into any new job or any such things. And don't resign. If you are having a stable job, don't resign in this time, like, you know. And learn to control your words. You may be misinterpreted and used by others. Whatever you talk could lead to something else, you know. And you also need to be very careful with your family members when you interact. Don't end up hurting people. And for you, the mantra of Mars only you have to chant. Om Kram Kreem Kram Saha Bhaumyaya Namaha or Om Am Angarakaya Namaha. You could chant this and you can donate gur, red cloth and whatever, like all these things what I suggested for the first Rashi, Mesh Rashi. And you could also chant Om Namah Shivaya and Mahamrityunjay Jap also is good for you. Then the next is Dhanu Rashi or Sagittarius. Avoid major decisions, no heavy investments. And donate yellow cloth or turmeric. A packet of haldi also is okay. Jaggery, gur, wheat, you know, after the eclipse is over. And whenever it is possible, you could feed few people also, like, you know, but to do it with respect. That's what is needed. Not necessarily Brahmins or any caste. I'm not telling that. Anybody, like, you know, if you feed Brahmins, good enough. Or if you don't get to feed them, you feed anybody who is hungry. Then Guru ka mantra is Om Gram Grim. Graum Saha Gurave Namaha. Or you can say Om Brahm Brahaspate Namaha. Then the next one is Makara Rashi. Makara Rashi or Capricorn. And for Makara Rashi, actually the Sadesati has begun and it is now in the maximum, like, you know, optimum period, like middle phase is going on for you all. You could watch my video on Sadesati. I have posted recently. And you as usual, you know, like now again Shani has gone retrograde, so you also should not neglect any minor health problem also. Please attend to it immediately. And you may experience some delays, like, you know, in your projects or in getting the payments, like, you know, anyway worldwide business is going to suffer. You may suffer a little more, that's it. And you have to do this Shani ka mantra, Bija mantra. Om Pram Prim Praum Sah Shanaye Namaha or Om Sham Shaneshcharaya Namaha. And after this eclipse is over, you could donate, you know, sesame seeds or til and donate oil, horse gram or kulit, what we say. And also you could donate grey cloth, okay? For Saturn, actually, you should not donate a black cloth and you should donate grey cloth. And then next one is a Kumbh Rashi or Aquarius. Adisati has begun for you people. So no heavy investment. If you are in a stable job, please don't change. And don't start any new venture, at least not for next 3 months at all. And every decision you take should be very well thought and taken. And you should control your words and your, you know, behavior towards your elders at home, especially the parents. Otherwise, you will spoil relations and you will end up hurting them. So, Shani ka mantra is like, you know, Om Pram Prim Pram Saha Shanaye Namaha or Om Sham Shaneshtaraya Namaha. You could chant this mantra. Again, donate and Mahamrityunjay Jap and Om Namah Shivaya also is going to help you immensely. And donate oil and then sesame seeds or til or horse gram and grey cloth as Makar Rashi people have to. Then the last one in the zodiac is like, you know, Meen Rashi or Pisces. This is not actually very good for Meen Rashi either. Meen Rashi may develop worrying tendency and, you know, kind of little bit of depression you will get into and that worklessness. And you might lose a job. You might immediately not get a very good job. But don't worry. Things will settle down after 3 months. Whatever, like, you know, you are there, just maintain status quo. That is what I would advise. and you need to meditate a lot to control your emotions and control your mind. Om Namah Shivaya and Mahamrityunjay Jap are really good for you. They will work well. And please don't get into any heavy investment. After the grahan is over, you could donate yellow cloth or, you know, or a packet of turmeric, then gur and then gehu. You also feed few people whenever it is possible. And chant this Guru Bija Mantra. Om Gram Grim Graum Saha Gurave Namaha. Or Om Brahm Brahaspataye Namaha. Now, Rahu and Ketu are common for all of us. Because see, actually Rahu is causing the eclipse. So we have to pray to Rahu. And Ketu is diagonally opposite. And also Rahu and Ketu are the part of the same this thing. One is the head and the other one is the tail. So it is better that you chant these two mantras also during the eclipse. And even after the eclipse, at least for next 3 months, whatever mantras I have suggested will work wonders for you. So for Rahu, Om Brahm Brim Brahm Saha Rahave Namaha. This is the Bija Mantra. And then otherwise, you can just simply chant Om Ram Rahave Namaha. And donate black cloth, then, you know, kambal, rug, or oil and til to the needy. And Ketu's Tantric Mantra is Om Sram Stream Straum Saha Ketave Namaha. Or Kim Ketave Namaha. And after the eclipse is over, donate some religious books. You know, whatever religion you belong to, you could donate some religious text or some religious book, a book of mantras or Bhagavad Gita or, you know, any of the Puranas or even Guru Granth Sahib. As per your religion, donate it to people who will literally use it. Don't donate, think that, okay, I will give it to my own sibling and my own son or my own daughter or my own brother, sister, who may not even open that book and see, then it is of no use. Such dana is of no use. That is why you have to find a satpatra and then give dana. Satpatra means a deserving people should get the dana. So give it in somewhere where it will be used and Ketu will be pleased with that. And you have to offer brown cloth and also kambal and oil and til after the eclipse is over. So these are the things, and there is nothing to get scared. These are all natural phenomena. And I'm sure all of us are there, and you know, all of us are blessed to be born in a country like India, and we seek a lot of protection from the deeds of good deeds done on this in our country. And also, like, you know, have faith in Almighty God. That is what is very, very important over here. So another thing is to get relief from Rahu's, whatever you are going, do Mata Ka Aradhana. It could be anybody like Durga or whatever Devi. Devi is a Devi. All forms are, all the Devis are forms of Parvati ultimately. So you could pray to Mata, whatever according to your faith. And that will help in reducing the ill effects of Rahu. So I hope you found this useful. Thank you very much, and God bless. Shubham Bhavati.